The beginning, Genesis 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the water. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw that the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning. And God said, "Let the world produce living creatures according to their kind, the livestock, the creatures that move along the ground, and the wild animals, each according to their kind." Then God said, "Let us make mankind in our own image, in our own likeness, so that they may rule over the fish in the sea, the birds in the sky, over the livestock, and over all the wild animals, each according to their own." And it was so. So God created man in his own image. Africa, the birthplace of humanity and the continent with the longest Earth's history, continues to fascinate researchers and advance analysis. The continent of Africa is about 4 times larger than the country of the United States of America. One of the major rivers in Ethiopia is the Awash. Its course is entirely contained within the boundaries of Ethiopia, and it empties into a chain of interconnected lakes that begin with Lake Gargan and ends with Lake Abi. The fertile Awash Valley, the abundance of food supply and shelter were idealistic conditions for the prehistoric man to develop and adapt to the new environment. The history of Africa begins with the prehistory of Africa and the emergence of Homo sapiens in East Africa. A number of varieties of Homo sapiens are grouped into a broad category of archaic humans in the period beginning 500,000 years ago. Lucy is the common name of AL-288-1. Several hundred pieces of bone, representing about 40% of the skeleton of an Australopithecus. Common name Lucy, age 3.2 million years, was discovered November 24, 1974. Archaeological inquiry has discovered several centers of very ancient civilization. These are Egypt, Mesopotamia, and the Indus Basin. In the earlier stages of investigation, these were treated as entirely separate from each other. That day and view has gone. The evidence that is constantly coming to light is beginning to give as glimpses of the possibility of one great widespread civilization composed of many cultures stretching from the shores of the Mediterranean and lying along the Persian Gulf to the Indian Ocean. Here, then, at the feet of the Western Eurasiatic Mountains, forming a peripheral margin to the upland regions, existed civilizations while the rest of the world was still hidden in primeval darkness. A look towards Egypt of antiquity is the best way to conceive and build our cultural future. The first Egyptian dynastic period dates back between 3050 to to 2890 BC, more than 5,000 years ago. The Egyptian pharaohs and scholars created great monuments, tombs, temples, and other wonders of the world, which still have the greatest scholars throughout time baffled with their great accomplishments. For thousands of years, the Egyptians flourished and migrated through Africa, India, Asia, and throughout the world. Because of the vastness of a continent so enormous, many African Americans have misconceptions of their heritage. The Egyptians had many great scholars. One of them was Imhotep, the father of medicine. They also discovered hieroglyphics, the first writing form. The Egyptian kings and pharaohs believed they would reincarnate into their afterlife, so often they built elaborate tombs deep in the chambers of the pyramids. The pharaohs believed that they would bring their valuables and jewels into their afterlife, so some of the corridors contained booby traps. These intricate labyrinths often led to the tombs of these great pharaohs with their golden treasures and precious jewels. The Egyptians created the first form of embalming or preserving their dead pharaohs and priests. Often referred to as mummification, the most famous of these mummies was a pharaoh from the 18th dynasty, King Tutankhamun, most commonly referred to as King Tut. The Egyptians believed that they would be able to transform into the afterlife with their golden treasures. They often were buried with their servants and also their guards to protect them. African American history encompasses not only the ability of our ancestors to overcome their afflictions of being stolen and robbed of their heritage.
The blackness became my home.